而疫情也扰乱了全世界的教育体系。英国学童去年平均损失了115天的学校教育，相当程度的阻碍了学习跟社交发展的能力，特别是对低收入跟少数族裔的学生。复课之后呢，校方是加强补课，并且强化软硬体设备，来因应未来可能的远距教学。
从去年至今，经历过3次全国大封锁之后，英国小学生很高兴再次回到学校，跟同学一起上课。这些孩子平均已经少上115天的学，校方不放弃，立刻加强阅读写作课程，还为6年级学生额外提供数学补课。
Have some children fallen behind? Absolutely. I would be naive to think that didn't happen. Is it up to the education system to give them the scaffold to build back up again?Absolutely.
圣家天主小学位在伦敦的贫穷社区，2/3的孩子来自非洲、加勒比海、南亚或者南美洲移民家庭，英文是第二语言。白人学生只占学生总数的12%。校方没钱没资源，全校100多个孩子只有8台笔记型电脑。疫情来袭时特别窘困，学生得在家里跟父母兄弟姐妹共用电脑上课，影响学习。校方找上慈善团体，联络企业捐赠电脑跟旧的办公家具等相关设备。当学生一人领到一台笔电，掩不住欣喜之情。
Very important because like now like children in school can use them for like work.And like if there's another lockdown, maybe they can like take them home if they don't have some at home.
We have a laptop, but there are more than one of us, so it helped. Because, you know, instead of having to share it, he had his own so he can, you know, catch up with work and do his work.
数位鸿沟只是问题之一。校方获得政府新一波追加资金，用来帮助需要身心辅导的孩子。有的学生因为疫情遭遇丧亲之痛，有的父母失业，连家都快要不保，还有些人居家太久，没有同侪朋友可以交流喘息，历经心理挣扎，这些都让校方非常重视，要跟学业一并照顾弥补起来。公视新闻，社会中编。